Self-Service Disability Compensation Claims Tool at va.gov. Section 3, Add Evidence. In Section 3, we'll review how veterans can add supporting evidence to their compensation claims using the new self-service tool. Section 3 starts with a notice on the screen that will ask where VA can find evidence and supporting documents related to the veterans' rated service-connected disabilities and/or their new service-connected disabilities or conditions. The main thing to keep in mind is the veteran will only need to submit evidence that VA doesn't already have. After clicking Continue, the few questions of this section appear. The tool asks the veteran if there is any evidence they'd like VA to review as part of their claim. Our sample veteran has chosen yes. They can then indicate what types of evidence they want us to review. The three options are VA medical records, private medical records, and supporting lay statements or other evidence. For further clarification on these options, the veteran can click on the drop-down prompt, "Which evidence type should I choose?" Our sample veteran has selected private medical records and supporting or lay statements or other evidence. The tool asks the veteran if they want to upload private medical records, to which our sample veteran has responded no. Since they select no, they must also check the patient acknowledgement box. Before checking this box, they can read the full text of the patient acknowledgement below. If the veteran had selected yes, the tool would have prompted them to upload their private medical records as a PDF, JPEG, or PNG. Your private medical record file should not be any larger than 25 megabytes in size. After uploading their documents, the veteran must specify the document type by choosing from a drop-down menu. Having clicked No, the veteran moves forward to provide information about where and when they received treatment. Veterans must name the private providers or hospitals that provided treatment, the first and last treatment dates, and the addresses of the medical providers. When it comes to VA retrieving information from these medical providers, veterans have the option of limiting the amount of information shared. This option is activated by selecting the consent box at the bottom of the page and specifying the limits of what can be shared. Next, the veteran has chosen to provide lay statements or supporting evidence. These files must be uploaded as PDFs, JPEGs, or PNGs, and they cannot be more than 25 megabytes. Our sample veteran has uploaded a file and specified that it is a Buddy lay statement. Moving forward with Continue, the veteran can see a summary of the uploaded evidence. Our sample veteran's private medical records and lay statements appear here. Finally, the tool describes next steps, including that VA will contact them if they need an exam and what they need to do if they have to reschedule an exam. The veteran can see more information by clicking the plus signs to the right of the boxes at the bottom of the page. This concludes Section 3 of the new Benefits Compensation Form, where we covered how users add supporting evidence. In the fourth section, the veteran will review their entered information and submit the Disability Benefits Compensation Form. The new Self-Service Disability Compensation Tool is located at www.va.gov/disability/how-2-file-claim.